Listen, O coastlands, to me, and listen, lend your ear, peoples from afar. Yahuwah has called me from the womb. He has made mention of my name from my mother's bowels. And he has made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand he has hidden me and made me a polished shaft. He has hidden me in his quiver and said to me, You are my servant, O Israel, in whom I will be glorified. For Zion's sake I will not be silent, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest, until its righteousness guards us as a brightness, and her salvation as a burning lamp. And the nations will see your righteousness, and all kings your glory, and you will be called by new name, which the mouth of Yahuwah will name. You also will be a crown of glory in the hand of Yahuwah, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. My name is Irina, Irina in Yeshua. I am a believer in Christ. I am a Messianic Jew. God brought me to this day so I can come to you and bring the word of His love, of His compassion. Over the years, as working with Him, now He brought me to the point that He is urging me to start talking to the body of Messiah. I have my own ministry through YouTube channel. It's called Irina in Yeshua. But today I would like to share with you something that He put on my heart, and it is very, very important for many people to understand. I would like to share with you the Word of God, because it is true prophecy that was given and established by the Word of many. I believe that prophecy can be revealed through the research of the Bible and the Scriptures. But before I am going to share with you, I would like to pray. Heavenly Father, Avinu Malkeinu, I ask you in Yeshua's name, please open our hearts today to understand your truth. Your word is the truth. O Heavenly Father, today is the day when it is a battle between darkness and light. Today is the day when we all going to make decisions, life, eternal life decisions. How we walk, how we guide it in our lives. Please help us to understand your truth. And I ask you, please, bless all listeners online today. Let their hearts be open to you, to the Holy Spirit, so they would understand your word, your truth, your basic truth. Let your glory be today among us and fill us with your holiness. Fill us with your wisdom. Fill us because we need you. You're the true source of life. You're the true source of light in our life. Please heal those who needed healing. Please reach those who are in desperation in their lives, who are searching you, who are screaming to you in their hearts for help. Please send your holy angels to minister to everyone who need any kind of needs, Heavenly Father. And I pray so this word won't be spoken by my wisdom, but through the fullness of your Holy Spirit through me. Make me a vessel of your Spirit, Heavenly Father. Make me a vessel of your love. Let be your will be done in our lives, Heavenly Father. In Yeshua's name. Amen. Today I would like to start a topic that perhaps for many people it's maybe simple topic, but it is very big topic. It's topic of sin, the origin and nature of sin. Today it will be a part one, and I would call it light versus darkness. What is sin? It is very simple question. Many people may say what's right and what's wrong. According to Webster Dictionary, sin, noun, the voluntary departure of a moral agent from a known rule of rectitude or duty prescribed by God. Any voluntary transgression of the divine law or violation of a divine command, a wicked act, iniquity. It looks simple to understand. In the English language, the word sin is an abstract word, and many people give different definition of sin. For many, sin has become an irrelevant word. Everyone has their own moral standards. These days, government may declare in the law of the land that sin is no longer sin and persecute those who disagree with them. People lose their anchor in the stormy sea of moral life. They no longer have the foundation of what is right and what is wrong. A whole generation is losing its guidelines in the chaotic life, and the main street church is going along with some moral corruption. I decided to start my own journey to find the truth about the origin and nature of sin. And if you're listening to me right now, join me in this journey to find the truth that sets us free. Let's go back to the origin of the word, which is in the scripture. The Hebrew language is a language of concrete thinking. Every word is tied to something that a person can see, feel, and connect in his life through experience. The very first time the word sin occurs in Genesis chapter 4, verse 7. It is story about Cain when he became jealous of Abel and he killed him. It is a Hebrew word hatath, a missing. This definition gives us a perfect picture of the sins when we have a target, a person who has to hit the target, and the action of the person who hits or misses the targets. To understand what sin represents, we have to find out what is the target, who is making the hit or miss, why and how are these hits and misses happening. The answer for this question, it will be probably later in my research. Who established the target? There is another question we have to find out. Who is in power to set up this target? Obviously, the whole human race, every person, all people on the earth, they have to make decisions. They have to make an action to reach certain target, and it's up to them if they hit it or miss it. So the action when a person misses the target is represents sin. I will research about, I will teach about this more in my second part of my study, but at this point I would like to share with you the word of God. Yeshua's last word to his disciples before his death, his last will for his children. I would like to share with you this word of God. In John chapter 16, verses 7-8, Yeshua was sharing and was talking to his disciples. But I tell you the truth, it is expedient for you that I go away, for if I do not go away, the Comforter will not come to you, but if I depart, I will send him to you. And when that one comes, he will convict the world concerning sin and concerning righteousness and concerning judgment. I would like to stop on this sentence and again to think about what did just Yeshua told to his disciples. These words were said just before his death on the cross. It was his last words to his disciples as a group before his death. And usually when people know they're going to die, they are given for his friends, for his family, for his dear children, the last word, the last will. And we have to be very, very careful examine what he have to say in this couple of chapters. And this is what he said, I have to go, because I have to send Comforter. We know that Comforter he was referring was is the Holy Spirit, because this one who comes, he will convict the world concerning sin, and concerning righteousness, and concerning judgment. This is very important to understand, that Holy Spirit, his whole goal on the earth, it is to convict the whole world concerning sin. This is the first, very first step. No one in the world can understand what sin is unless the Holy Spirit will convict him in his sins. It is a revelation of God. Without conviction of our sins, we cannot understand our trespasses before God. And without understanding, we cannot make tshuva, return back to him through repentance. Therefore, it is very important to understand what sin is, because it is directly connected to the revelation of the Holy Spirit. At the same time, he will convict also the whole world concerning righteousness. Righteous person, in Hebrew word, tzaddik. Sin is chatat, understanding of sin and understanding of righteousness. They're going hand by hand, because sin is opposition of righteousness. The Holy Spirit wants us to understand about righteous way to live, and then he is going to convict the world about judgment. Judgment for every single one on the earth. Judgment of good and judgment of evil. We're all going to stand before God and all going to give an answer for every single action in our lives, for every single thoughts in our lives, in every single motivation of our heart in our lives. Therefore, I pray that the Holy Spirit will guide us right now and give us revelation, not just only a word and knowledge, but also the revelation of him, what sin is. And I pray so those people who are listening right now, they would receive from you, God, from the Holy Spirit, this personal revelation about sin that convicts them for their own salvation. The next verses I would like to read represent the great conflict between light and darkness. The Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 1 and 5. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Elohim, and the Word was Elohim. He was in the beginning with Elohim. All came to be through him, and without him not even one came to be that come to be. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. I would like to stop on this verse. We see in the very beginning, Apostle John described what was importance of the coming of Yeshua on the earth. He told in him was life, and the life was the light of men. Right here, I would like to focus on this word light of man and the connection between light and life. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. As we see right here in these verses, Apostle John already show and start revealing about great conflict between light and between darkness, that Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, was the light, and he came into this world that was in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. It tried, but it did not succeed. In another verses, it says, verses 9-11, chapter 1 of Gospel of John, he was the true light, which enlightens every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. Right here again, it shows that he was the true light, which enlightens every man. This verse is showing us that every man, every single one, is in the darkness unless Yeshua, HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, will enlighten him through the Holy Spirit, because he is the true light. In verse 14, we read, "And the Word became flesh and pitched his tent among us, and we saw his esteem as of only brought forth our Father, complete in favor and truth." There is another chapter, very famous chapter, many Christians like to quote this verse. It's the Gospel of John, chapter 3:16. I would like to read in context what it's all about, because if we read just one verse, it may not represent the whole picture. We have to see in what context we can understand what was saying before and what was saying after. This word was saying when Yeshua HaMashiach had been talking to Nicodemus, who was a Pharisee, who was a very learned person. He knew the Torah and the scriptures very well. He had understanding of many things in the Bible. And yet, when Yeshua started talking to him about heavenly things, about things that spiritual things, he did not understand. And this is, he told previously of this verses that I'm going to read. He told, you have to be born again. If you will not be born again, you cannot see and you cannot enter into the kingdom of heaven. And Nicodemus did not understand how a person can be born again, because he cannot go back in mother's womb. And Yeshua told, those who are born from spirit is spirit, and those who are born from flesh is flesh. He compared this, that there is a birth from in the flesh and there is a birth in the spirit. And people who are born in the flesh, they're not yet born in the spirit, and this is why Yeshua come to this earth, so we would be born in the spirit to see and to enter into his kingdom. And this is what is important, because his kingdom is the kingdom of light, and he come into this darkness, and darkness tried to overcome him. We see this, the great conflict between light and the darkness, between two kingdoms that represent, one by Yeshua represent kingdom of light, and one by his enemy represent the kingdom of darkness. I would start from verse 16 of chapter 3, Gospel of John. "For Elohim so loved the world, that he gave his only brought forth Son, so that everyone who believes in him should not perish, but possess everlasting life. For Elohim did not send his Son into the world to judge the world, but that world through him might be saved. He who believes in him is not judged, but he who does not believe is judged already, because he has not believed in the name of the only brought forth Son of Elohim. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and the men love the darkness rather than the light, for their works were wicked. For everyone who is practicing evil matters hates the light, and does not come to the light, lest his works should be exposed. But the one doing the truth comes to the light, so that his works are clearly seen, that they have been wrought in Elohim." It says that he come, so the world through him might be saved. This is a question, from what we have to be saved. And this is a judgment, that the light has come into the world. It is a judgment for the darkness, when light comes to the world. And yet the men love the darkness rather than the light, for their work were wicked. Here we see the connection between wickedness and darkness. This is how disciple John described this great conflict between darkness and between light. And it is involve sin and righteousness at the same time. "For everyone who is practicing evil matters hates the light." What are evil matters? What is sin? What is this? Because we surround it right now in our generations. People confused. Many things that long before, many years before, there was sin. Now they declare it's not sin anymore. And the younger generation confused because they so much remove from the righteousness. They don't see the righteousness anymore. They so desensitized in their sins. They live in the sin and they even don't know about. And they think that they do good before God. And they describe that God is love. But they don't understand that God is light and in Him there is no darkness. If you have darkness inside of you, how in the earth you can think that you can stand before the light and not to be exposed? Everything will be revealed in the future judgment. Unless the sins are forgiven, unless the sins forgiven through repentance, you'll be exposed to this light. And everybody gonna see it, what your life is. You cannot whitewash anymore your life. You cannot pretend and to be hypocrite. You cannot play double life anymore. You cannot smile everybody and pretend that you love them. But deep inside and heart, it's a darkness of hate. You cannot, because the Holy Spirit is going to reveal every single sin. You think you can hide your thoughts, your dirty thoughts deep down inside of you. But I want to tell you, the Holy Spirit will reveal every single thought you made in your life. And you're going to give the answer before God, Almighty God. Who is the light? Who is the true light? And right now, I want you to think about, please, please, look, repent, stand before God on your knees and say, forgive me because I didn't know what I was doing, because I was ignorant in my life. And this is what? And this is the judgment. That the light has come into the world. And the light, right now we live in a such time when the light, Yeshua HaMashiach, He will come again on this earth. He will stand with His feet in His glorified body. He is no more, will be human like us who could be despised or could be treated badly, and He will be meek and weak. He will be the King of Kings. He will be a Lord of Lords. He will come with the sword in His mouth that will spoken because He is the Word. And He will judge everybody on the earth. This is the judgment. The light will come on this earth. And He will judge everybody. He will judge living and dead. He will judge every single person. Christians, not Christians, believers, not believers, everybody gonna be judged by Him. And if a person loves the darkness rather than the light, and his work were wicked, there will be a consequences, very dear consequences of this. For everyone who is practicing evil matter hates the light. And we see right now what is going on. The more people, the more society going into deep darkness, they become hateful to any light that comes to any believers. They hate this light. They persecute believers all over the world. They cannot stand this light. If you open up a certain infested cockroaches and bugs places. Have you ever seen infested cockroaches places, houses? When there is a dark, they will come out and they will go right in the middle of the room and they will live their little dirty lives. But as soon as you flip this light switch and the light starts shining on them, they cannot stand it. They run away. They go into these little hiding places. And this is what's going to happen in the last days. They will go into their hidings, like in the Revelation. They will cry, "Oh, mountains, hide us. We cannot stand before judgment of God. Because He is the power. He knows what He is doing. And we are believers. We are who are believers. We have to stand and be prepared to be persecuted, because who we are, we have to understand, we are part of the kingdom of light. We are part of this kingdom, and we represent Yeshua HaMashiach in this life. We become a vessel of His light. We are like little lamps that shine in this world of darkness. And we will be persecuted in the same way, because they don't like it. They want to extinguish all light, because they persecute Yeshua. They kill Him. And Yeshua told, they will persecute you. Why? Because this is the great conflict between light and darkness. But the one doing the truth come to the light. Those who do in righteousness, they love the light. Those who wants to do righteousness, they come to this light, shiny light of presence of God. And they stand and they enjoy this light. And they get healed under this light. But those who are doing the truth come to the light, so that His work are clearly seen, that they have been wrought in Elohim. This is what all about. We have to be shining. Our lives have to be example to the world, how we have to be. We cannot compromise with the world, with the darkness. We cannot, because it is great conflict, and you are in the middle of it. There is a sin, there is a darkness. And where is the righteousness, there is a light. You have to choose right now where you're gonna be, what walk you're gonna walk. Are you going to use compromise in your life, or are you going to decide whom you follow? Are you following the light? Are you following Yeshua HaMashiach in His righteousness? Not your righteousness, not your understanding what is right is what is wrong, but His righteousness, His commandments, His rules that He established from the generations before us. And they do not change just because in this generation they decide that they can't change the law of God. They cannot change, because they stand and they stand and they stand. Because He is the word that was spoken before many generations before us. It was written in the scripture. It was sealed with the Holy Spirit. And now it represented to us. And you have to deal with that. You cannot complain. Because this is what you have to do. Take it, or you're gonna be destroyed by darkness.
Yevrechecha Adonai veishmirecha. Ya'er Adonai panavilecha vegunecha. Yaseh Adonai panavilecha vaiselecha shalom.